All right, Brian, how many weeks out are we from Ironman Florida?
Don't remind me. I don't know. Six?
I think just under seven, yeah. Seven or six. To another full week of training video. As you can see, this is a little bit different from the last few weeks of training. I'm not in Chicago anymore. I'm currently in the sunny state, the sunny and very hot state of Austin, Texas. The reason I actually came here though is to go back home. I'm actually gonna be moving out here in a week, but I thought while I'm here, why not take you through what a week of training looks like with the NVDM team and all my athletes and other coaches. But yeah, big thanks to Brian for picking me up at the airport and bringing me back to my apartment. Thank you, Brian, I appreciate that. But it is currently Monday. I'm just doing an easy recovery swim. About halfway done, actually no, I'm more than halfway done. I'm 3K in, have another K to do, so I'll be 4K on the day, back in the meter pool. And then after this, we get to go to physical therapy. Very excited to get some needles stuck in me, dry needling done. Because yesterday we had a pretty long run. I actually made a video on that. So definitely make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out. I'm gonna be posting a lot of fun and interesting content leading up to Ironman Florida, where the goal is to qualify for Kona and go 8:30. So if you wanna see if I can accomplish that, yeah, hit that subscribe button. But as I mentioned, swim, then physical therapy, then we have a easy recovery bike ride in the afternoon. And then tomorrow, usually Tuesdays are pretty hard, but we're kind of deloading this week, so tomorrow won't be too bad. But I think my good friend Jonathan is coming over to knock out a trainer session together. So yeah, I think I'll pick up the camera tomorrow when he's there. I think he's actually getting ready for Waco 70.3, so yeah, he should go pretty. He's a young kid, he's only like 18 years old, and he's he's fast, he's super fast. But yeah, I'm gonna go finish up the swim so I'm not late for PT, and catch you tomorrow. Did I mention it's hot here? Well, actually not that hot right now, it's cloudy, but man, we did 18 miles yesterday in 100 degree heat. My core temperature hit 102 degrees. That's how hot it was. Well, it is Tuesday morning. We got Jonathan here in the triathlon frat house. What's your workout, Jonathan?
I got an hour and a half of 5x5K time trials, I think.
Hour and a half, 5x5K. What's the time on that?
So like 8 minutes.
8 minutes. So Jonathan's got 5x8 minutes. I had a swim this morning, 50 by 25, a lot of 25s, and now I'm about to hop on the bike here. I don't have too hard of a workout today, just a cadence one, just some spin-ups because I had a big weekend. So taking a bit of a deload, but I'll do 2 hours or so on the bike, and then 40-minute runoff or so. How long is your run?
30 minutes.
30 minutes. You have 800s, right?
Yeah, 800s.
Yeah, Jonathan's got some 800s. although he has a math lesson that he's getting ready for the ACT. You gotta head out right after that. Yeah. But yeah, I'm gonna knock out this workout, and then it's not gonna be too exciting, honestly, just me biking for 2 hours. So maybe I'll catch you guys on the run. If not, I'm gonna go swim again. And then, we'll catch you sometime later in the day. I'm here enjoying my recovery ride. Jonathan is
not
dying in his second of five, but I believe in him. I think he'll get it done. Stay tuned, I'll update you guys. Well, Jonathan, you make it?
Yeah, survived it.
All five?
Yeah.
Here we go. Nailed it. Now, I'm about halfway done with this guy. And then, we got the run. Got Coach Natasha here. Got a quick swim lesson. Ready? All right.
So the rotation looks better.
Yeah.
I mean, are you purposefully thinking about that there?
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
Yeah. So it definitely looks better.
Uh huh.
For some reason, though, the arm is still kind of coming out, not as fluent as the right side.
Yeah.
So I need to why that is, if it's a arm mobility issue or you're not finishing your stroke. So
okay, with my left arm.
Okay.
All right, got it. I'll do another 50.
Breathing, you just kind of swing that arm around.
Yeah.
More relaxed. And so it's a thinking of the side you're breathing, it almost looks like you're finishing your stroke more.
Yeah.
And then this arm is much bigger over the water and you're getting a lot more wingspan.
Okay.
Where the other side, when you're not breathing to it looks like it comes out here and then it enters here.
Yeah.
And it looks just very tense. Like I can see your arm muscles.
Oh.
So I would say.
Okay, well, decided to show up. Long time no see. How's your workout going?
Going good.
Yeah, what do you have?
10 by 100 pull.
Oh, it's not bad.
Not bad at all.
Yeah. All right. I need to work on windmilling my bad arm, which I think is my right arm or my left arm, whatever arm.
Do you breathe just from inside?
Yeah, I breathe through the left side, but then my right side is my right arm. It doesn't windmill right, so it's really tense. And Natasha said she can see my arm muscles.
Yep.
Which is not good.
So, grab a buoy.
Gonna work on that.
There's babies back there.
All right, we made it to the bike store. Rami, you took care of my bike, right?
What's up?
All right, am I gonna go, am I going 415 at Ironman Florida?
Oh
yeah? Yeah, I got it. If I don't go 415 on the bike, it's this guy's fault. No, if you guys are ever in the Austin area, come and check out Austin Tricyclist and ask for this guy. He's the best mechanic they have. But yeah, I'm gonna go pick up my bike and oh, is this the new Wahoo shift?
Jeez.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick up my bike and got a big run tomorrow, so get to bed early.
It was one of those nights where I felt like I was home, but like I was
out. Good to get going. Before we get going, we have a couple new faces and visiting faces. So if you're new, you'll just quickly say your name and then what you're getting ready for. So
Kim Dowchick, I'm in Florida.
Okay. If guys, most of you know Bobby.
Yeah. I'm his
Ken's wife, and then she's visiting from
Pittsburgh,
Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
And then doing Ironman Florida with you all. Anyone else? Okay, and then congrats. Who raced this weekend? Yeah.
TJ.
Everyone, well done, Matt. Everyone had a great race, so congratulations to you all. Because of that, and because of the fact that we did a hard run this weekend for most of us, today's just an easy run. And so what we're going to do is, this is actually closed off because of
ACL,
thank you. So we're actually just going to hit the trail. So try not to, it's dark on the trail for this first section, so just watch your footing. But for most of you, just go out.
Just started the progression. Going to go out at a 7-minute pace for the first one, and then, yeah, pick it up a bit. See how it goes. Sun's finally coming out, so finally see a little bit. What's the warm-up, coach?
3-2-3.
3-2-3? Are you hopping in here?
Not okay. Going to
the
Join me, my camping.
I'll go with you.
Hopping in, Jonathan?
Yeah, hopping in.
All right, 3-2-3. And then
so
hold
take
five.
It really easy, and then hold 6 through 10, and that 6 through 10 or 5 through 10 is your goal race pace for your upcoming race. So Waco 70.3, Ironman Florida, whatever you have coming up.
Oh, 122.
Like, we're dead.
You guys did a 122?
Oh, jeez. Yeah. We're done.
I did a 132.
That's what I wish we did.
With 2 by 200, your goal is to extend what you do on the 100s to affirm the pace of your race pace, and then 1 by 300, okay? 2 by 200, 1 by 300. So if you mess it up on the first 200, you have another opportunity to do it better, okay?
How about 300 and then 2 by 200?
No.
It's better than a 1, 2, 3, 4 and a 500.
Yes.
Yeah.
What's the difference? Then extend.
I like extending and then it's shorter.
I know.
Yeah.
Okay. 2 by 200. Let's do it. Take 20 seconds rest between each.
What were you ending up holding over there for your
5 100? Yeah,
I held 125 for every
240. 245.
So there was no descent.
Yeah. Okay.
Just
200,
sorry.
250, low
250s. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to try to hold
250. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, let's go here on the 20. Random, but I'm going to get a stopwatch on.
Alrighty.
On the 15.
What are we resting
ready?
In between?
20. 20 seconds. Okay, get ready. And let's go.
Just have a easy 4K recovery swim. You guys saw enough of me splashing around trying not to drown yesterday, so not gonna film much of this. No pain today, thank God. Only pain is the monotony of swimming and staring at a black line for an hour and 20 minutes, but we'll get it done.
little dazed.
No worries.
A little bit of a headache going on here. You know, as far as actual real strength training goes, during the season, 1 to 2 sessions is probably plenty. But in the off season, I would increase that.
Hey. Here comes the. Y'all don't really want it like. Well, pretty solid day today. Just a boring swim, boring bike, and now we just finished up a strength session. Filmed it, but it's not going to be in this video. I'm going to make a separate video on strength training for triathletes with Coach Harold, so check out that video. Probably be coming out next week or in a couple weeks. I don't know when. But yeah, now it's time. Jonathan, where are we headed now?
Back home.
Actually, we're headed to Taco Bell first to get a new chicken enchilada burrito. And then we're headed home. So yeah, we'll catch you tomorrow. Ready for tomorrow's swim workout, Jonathan? Ready for tomorrow's swim?
I don't know what it is.
It's gonna be a fun one.
Get you down, you know what you gotta do?
I don't wanna know what you gotta do.
Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming. What do? We swim, swim.
Dory, no singing.
Dory. I love to swim and
Dory.
The second one was my slowest.
The second one? Yeah. What was that? Just trying to get my
55?
Yeah.
And then all
50s. Yeah, once you've hopped in here, it's like you're able to put the energy up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amazing. I remember when, like last year at this time, it was like trying to go to Arizona.
Yeah.
You're trying to break through.
Yeah.
It's like a big deal.
What did you do?
Extra 50, probably.
Yeah.
Oops.
Someone's a little tired.
Okay, guys, keep strong, baby. It's just doing easy 500 feet low. It's a big swim, so we're going to keep you guys going.
And then before Texas, I was just like 259.
Yeah.
So it's like 10 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, that's a big draw. Right?
Yeah.
That's a
next year, I'll be 230s. Jonathan and I out here, got easy 8 miles to do. And yeah, what you think of the swim today, Jonathan?
It was awesome, 5K.
Yeah, Jonathan hit 5K. I got 4,700. So definitely a big boy swim today. But yeah, we just have this run, then some plyos, and then headed to physical therapy. So should be a good day. Gonna wrap up the training for Friday. Didn't really do much after physical therapy. Hopped on the bike for 90 minutes and then hit the sauna. That's about it. Yeah, it's about 5 o'clock now, so I'm gonna get my 10,000 bottles ready for tomorrow. We got a hard swim, hard bike, hard run, so should be a good day. Hopefully, we'll see. Hopefully the bike goes better than last week. Yeah, should be a good time. I think I'll catch you guys either at the pool, on the bike, or on the run. Or maybe after all the festivities. Yeah, we'll see. Just finished up 10 100s. I'm not sure what was worse, these or the 10 200s yesterday. These were a lot faster than yesterday. But yeah, gonna cool it down and then head home. We got a pretty tough the bike workout we gotta do after this. So, yeah. We are 90 minutes, one banana and one bottle into the ride. Have another 3 hours to go, just did the warm up. Have some, I probably already put the workout on screen, but it's just efforts at Ironman pace with some surges. So hopefully shouldn't be too painful, but they always end up hurting pretty bad. Jonathan, how you feeling?
I'm alive.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Jonathan has a big workout today as well, so probably won't film too much, we'll see. But yeah, we gotta run off. Too, so should be a good one. Oh, and we have some jelly beans on tap for extra carbs. Cheers. Everybody, yeah. Rock your body, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Rock your body right.
Again, brothers, sisters, everybody sing. Gonna bring the flame, I'll show you how. Got a question for you, better answer now. Yeah,
am I original?
Yeah,
am I the only one?
Yeah,
am I sexy?
You're done.
Hey.
Let's go! And now you're on the ground. Get a push harder. Well, I kind of forgot and kind of didn't really want to take the GoPro on the run because it was a pretty hard run. And it's never fun having to run with a camera, so. Jonathan and I finished the run. We did 2x20 minutes. I was supposed to do 3x1.5 miles, but I wanted to join Jonathan on his last hard workout before he heads off to 70.3 Waco. Gonna do well there. But yeah, it was a hard run. It was hot. I'll put the splits and stuff on screen. But we got back. Then we filmed a review of some Idaho potato French fry milkshake ice cream, which you should check out the full review if you want to see what Jonathan thought of that one. I thought it was pretty good, but he had other ideas. And the bike, I should talk about the bike. The bike went well, better than last week, I think. Didn't fail it, so that's always good. Yeah, and now I'm gonna go put my bottles
into my dishwasher because they're dirty, and get stuff ready for tomorrow's run. Eat, do some work, and go to bed. It's already like 4:35, so yeah, that's what happens when you spend the entire day training, gets away from you. But yeah, solid day of training. Nothing to complain about, really. Yeah, catch you guys tomorrow, I guess, on the long run.
Those 7 minute miles in this like heat humidity was gonna kill me. So I was like, oh,
you can do
like,
it.
I'm sure I could, but.
We are not doing 7 minute miles.
Not so much. Yeah.
Welcome everyone to the inaugural Parker Run Club. We have Brian and Ryan. gonna knock out easy run. Hoping for at least 13 today. How's that sound?
Yeah, sounds good.
We'll do a 10 mile loop and a 3 mile loop. All right.
Cool.
Knock out 13 today and then call the morning. You guys ready?
Yeah. Let's do it.
All right, Brian, let's finish this video the same way we started. How many weeks out from Florida?
5 weeks.
Five, are we five?
Yeah.
Those four.
Don't get hit.